Hello friends, we are continuing our discussion of this test 4. All right, part test 4, question number 75. Look at question number 75. In 75, this is actually, this should be CH2. There are some printing mistakes, and this is stated with this is X means I'm assuming that this is bonded to X. And now I am again assuming that it undergoes SN1 as well as E1, and we have to consider all the products including stereoisomers. Alright, this is what I am assuming from the question, because this is what I got. Alright, this is what I got. So I am assuming that there is no double bond, etc. And this is simply CH2X, and it shows SN1 and E1, and consider all the products including stereoisomers. So let us see question number 75. See, in question number 75, if it is E1 or SN1 initial stage, we get this kind of carbocation. E1 is a, or SN1 is a two-step mechanism. In the first step we get carbocation. All right, now suppose this carbocation is produced. Now 1-2 shift takes place, and due to 1-2 shift we get this kind of carbocation. This H positive gets shifted here. All right, so we get this kind of carbocation. Now if it shows even mechanism, means if it is even elimination, so there are two possibilities, like hydrogen may be removed from this carbon atom, then we get this kind of alkene, that is 2-methylbut-1-ene, or we get this kind of product, that is 2-methylbut-2-ene. This will be the major product. This is called Seltzer product. This is called this also means this is comparatively less branched. This is comparatively less branched. This is comparatively more branched. No, we cannot say. Yes, methyl group. Yes, Seltzer product and Hoffman's product. Now similarly, from here, if it undergoes SN1 mechanism, if it undergoes SN1 mechanism, or this nucleophile attacks on this carbon atom, and we get this product. All right, whereas this one, if it undergoes E1 mechanism, if it undergoes E1 mechanism, that is elimination, and this hydrogen is removed, and we get this kind of alkene. From this carbocation also we get this alkene, and if this carbocation undergoes SN1 mechanism, we get this kind of product. And now this is optically active, so we get two forms, R and S. So one, this alkene, two, they will not exhibit geometrical isomerism. 1, 2, 3, and this will also not exhibit optical isomerism. So 1, 2, 3, and then 2, 3 plus 2, 5, total product should be 5 in my view again. So I went for this one. Question number 76, again the reactant is not given, NBS is given. So I assumed, actually in this question also I assumed the reactant. Otherwise, you can leave this question, that is 76C. I assumed that this one was CH3 because NBS is given. NBS shows N-bromosuccinamide shows allylic or benzylic bromination. So that is why I took CH3. But the problem is, from the product, again, I'm not able to guess. So you have, from this, I have started NBS, all right, this one bromo, then KSH, nucleophilic substitution, so CH2SH. So I tried to find this product from these options, but I'm not getting it. But I am having only one CH2SH. From this, I guess that the reactant should have been this kind of thing. All right, then you can go for this option. Otherwise, you can cancel this question, whatever. Question number 77, in place of 77, I replaced it because this means even in the it is not clear to me. So question number 77, in place of question number 77, this question, प्रश्न नंबर 77 दिस ओएच एंड सीओएच एंड इट इज ब्रोमिनेटेड सो ऑब्वियसली आई टोल्ड यू इन केस ऑफ ओएच और एनएच2 एंड एट पैरा पोजीशन और ऑर्थो पैरा पोजीशन सीओएच और SO3H इफ इट इज ट्रीटेड ऑल द थ्री पोजीशंस गेट सब्स्टिट्यूटेड दैट इज दिस रिएक्शन इज एक्चुअली इप्सो मींस आईपीएसओ अटैक राइट नाउ क्वेश्चन नंबर The next question, question number 78. Question number 78. This is again pinacol-pinacolone rearrangement, 78. See, OH-OH, first step you have to remove H2O. From any position you can remove it because both are symmetrical. So first you created this positive charge here. Then this migration which includes expansion of ring. So 1, 2, 3, 4 and now we have this is first carbon atom having positive charge bearing OH first then 2, 3, 4, 5, 5th alright and then this ring alright so positive charge is produced over this first carbon atom and again removal of H2O and you get this kind of alkene alright so this is the product. Whereas there after migration H2O is removed and cyclopentanone should have been formed but we don't have, we are not given that option. We are not given that option. Look at the question paper. We are not given that option having CO group. See, first, second, so we opted that as a removal of H2O. All right. Because it is only H positive is mentioned. Question number 79. It is chloroform and KOH. So it is simply Riemer-Tiemann reaction. Alright. So the major product is this. That is CHO at ortho position. Because para position is already occupied. Then question number 80. During debromination of meso. Dibromobutane, meso dibromobutane, question number 80. So we have to use that is cis alkene anti addition and racemic mixture. And during debromination of meso, and see it works in opposite direction as well. If it is optically active and anti-elimination take place, we get cis. Alright. So, we have mesoform. So, it is, if it is cis, syn addition and meso. And we have trans and anti addition, we get meso. Trans, syn addition, we get racemic mixture. So look at this case, trans anti addition meso, from meso, this is meso dibromo, alright, you can draw the structure like meso, see, this is Br, CH3 and H, alright, so for anti elimination this group should be shifted like this, there should be anti periplanarity. So now one Br is removed from this end and second Br is removed from this end, opposite end, then only elimination will take place. So, or just remember this, we are given mesoform and it is anti elimination. You must remember debromination or dehalogenation is anti elimination, so it must be trans. So simply say the product, the reactant was trans to butene. This is better. You remember car and then from car you should be able to produce these three. Cis, anti, racemic mixture, cis, syn, addition, mesoform, then trans, anti, mesoform, trans, syn, addition, racemic mixture. Alright. Now look at question number 81. It says that chiral C7H16O2-diol is oxidized by PCC. Alright, PCC again pyridinium chlorochromate used to oxidize OH group into CHO group basically, or if it is secondary OH group, it is oxidized to CO group. Anyway, two achiral C7 means you should be careful. Initial diol was chiral, and the product is achiral. All right, so this thing you must remember. These are the given substances. So let us see what I did. I converted these compounds, like this compound, into CH3COH, and this is actually, again, printing is not printing is of poor quality. This is OH, means it is dash. So this at dash position, and this is at this position. So 81, look at question number 81, and it says that it is the first one is achiral. So I made it achiral by putting these OH group at one side and CH3 CH3, so I made a plane of symmetry. So this is due to plane of symmetry, this is achiral. All right, and now this one and this structure, if OH and OH are on opposite side, it is chiral. So basically we are starting from this chiral mixture. This is chiral. This chiral substance is oxygenated or using treated with PCC. So obviously initially this is chiral. All right, this is initially chiral. SS, that is notation, we don't need this. And finally, when it is oxygenated, we are getting this product, that is this one, COCO. So now we are left with no asymmetric carbon in the product. So this is achiral. All right, we don't have asymmetric carbon. Here we have this chirality. So we have to draw this structure in which OH and OH should be on opposite side. OH and OH should be on opposite side. That is why I opted this one. That is one with dash and one with wedge. All right. Whereas here both are wedge position. Both are wedge means both are at same side. And this is also, it is not clear. In this structure, this is not clear. So I opted the second option. Now question number 82. Look at question number 82. Says, okay, this is simple. NaOI, again you should remember, NaOI. NaOI is basically used for CHI3 haloform test. All right. So CO, initially, in initial stages, it will we will get this compound CO, and this is converted to CHI3 and COONA, and in the presence of H positive, it is converted to COH. Now see, this is again very interesting, very important. At any carboxylic acid at ortho position, this is alpha carbon. At alpha carbon, if any electron withdrawing group is attached, and if it is heated, decarboxylation takes place and we get this product. So this is very important, interesting also. You should be very clear about this. So this is question number 82. The correct answer is CHI3 and this one. All right,